Hello everybody, my name is Invicta. Welcome back to RimWorld. We have ourselves quite the job today. First off, thank you everybody for the continued support in the RimWorld series. Secondly, this video is going to be a little bit shorter than usual just because I am recording this very late. For those of you who watched today's Isaac episode, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And thirdly, we have ourselves a little bit of an issue here taking down this psychic ship. Now, people automatically were saying just use the mortars, aggro them to the kill box, wham bam, thank you ma'am, that's all you gotta do. Problem is that we have to be accurate with the mortar shots. Now, I'm still planning on doing that. People were saying that as if I wasn't going to do that already. But trust me, your boy was thinking about it. It just comes down to being able to actually hit the targets. So we only have 2 anti-grain warheads. We have 12 high explosive shells, 22 incendiary shells. So thanks to us holding out the... you know what? Go ahead and finish the wild boar hunt. It's all right. You know, it's not like we have a psychic ship or anything over here. Starvation. Baynard. It's from the muscle parasites. Gut worms, yeah. Yeah, so gut worms will actually affect their hunger because they're effectively tapeworms. Okay, so we're going to keep the animals. I want to keep all animals inside the barn for now, except for the chickens, of course, because I do not want them to be shot while we are engaging the mechanoids. Okay, Husky's eating currently. Husky, what are you doing after you eat? Harvesting cotton. Sinvicta's just hunting. Okay, so Sinvicta will be the person to man this. Okay, before we fire our first shot, let's make sure that our kill box is on. No. Husky, if you just turn that on real quick. But again, thank you everybody for supporting the RimWorld series. I really do appreciate it, and I'm glad that everyone continues to like it. As I said yesterday, it's a game that's well worth your time. It's a wonderful game, and I'm very, very happy that people are getting a lot of enjoyment out of it. It truly does enjoy it. It deserves your attention and your play. Secondly, here we go. Force target. Is this going to hit or is it not? Well, let's find out which Sinvicta woke up to smell the insomnia today. Gonna be a swing and a miss. It's a swing and a miss. It's a swing and a miss. Husky, do not go into that night. Thank you, Coach. How about everyone gets back in the base? Caravan from the Republican Federation of Refunue is approaching here. Is that a good trader? Is the uncle of Jenna and Force Strategy Gaming. Well, it's a shame that they're coming over from this side, because I would love them to go from the north, because then I would just aggro them on top of the psychic ship. How about we keep everyone inside the base for now? How many shells are we down, Sinvicta? How you doing here, buddy? Okay, so you've used about 9 shots. How about we have Husky do this, since you're awful, and we'll keep everybody else inside of the base for now, and you should never ever touch anything again. So we'll have everyone but Husky stay indoors. And I realize I could try to make a little bit of a better area for them, but this just keeps it easier on me. No, Husky, you understand. I need you to man this. Also, we need Daisy to come talk to these people. Daisy, you're not. Oh yeah, she has to try. Oh, wait, no. Isn't someone inspired to trade? Yes, it's Coach Krendor. Okay, so Coach is going to do the trade. Never mind. Okay, Daisy, you're back to staying inside like a little puppy that you are. Stay indoors. Coach Krendor, it's time to make the big-time trading plays. While Husky attempts to hit a psychic ship that I was not able to. Or he can also just keep on missing, too. It's whatever. Eventually, we'll hit it. Okay. We could buy a boomalope. No, thank you. We'll take all your components. We'll take all your advanced components. Hyperweave, we don't really need. We can make our own glitter world medicine eventually. You can have our anti-grain warheads because we're never going to use them. Plasteel, we've got a lot of plasteel. We don't need to spend any more money on that. Prosthetic heart, prosthetic arm. We've got a little bit of gold here. We don't really have a whole lot that they can sell us. I could buy another mega screen television, but I think we're splurging enough as it is, and they're not going to buy anything that we have. So, yeah, we'll eat the $1,300 for the steel components. Generally speaking, I will say this. Generally speaking, you don't really want to buy. You don't want to buy components and stuff from. Also, I realize that we don't have a wall here. Generally speaking, you don't want to buy materials and stuff from an exotic goods trader because their prices are generally pretty high. I think we hit a rat. Yeah. Good job, Husky. You killed a rat. Ooh, just use the mortars. You'll hit the mortars just fine, Zinvicta. Alright, well. Just remember, YouTube commenters, you're the ones who said this. Alright, you know what, Coach? I'm gonna go ahead and take a page out of Coach Crendor's playbook here real quick. He's not gonna get hit by Husky. Nah, not Coach. Coach's got the reflexes of a fox. Okay, time to run. Time to run, Coach. Oh god, the Scyther's way faster than him. Okay, there we go. Alright, Coach, you can just go stay inside. Oh, Coach, what are you doing? Husky landed it on the centipede. Oh, Coach, you gotta run. Oh, that's a charge rifle. My kidney destroyed? It shot him in the right kidney from that range. Okay, game. Hey, we're gonna need that kidney. Little Daisy. Yeah, so that kidney you've got. Turns out we're actually gonna need that. Thanks. Little Daisy, if you can just take this. Hey, a chain shotgun. That's very kind of them to kill one of their own members. You can just haul these. I'd appreciate it. Haul this as well. So yeah, so the whole mortar thing, this is kind of what I was talking about. Alright, Husky, you're free to go. Here's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping that the mechanoids fight these jerks. I mean, look, they killed one of their own inside of our kill box. They're straight up trying to set us up for murder, and I'm not going to take it. Okay, so let's go ahead and get that right kidney just fixed here. Install right kidney. And I'm gonna actually wake Jenna to do this. Need material. Where are they going? Ah, oh, they're going out that way. Ah, you idiots. Okay, well at least thank you for the chain shotgun. Thank you. Okay, I want somebody to work on Coach Crandall when he's able to walk. Yeah, everyone, I don't want you going out there yet. How are we gonna deal with this? It's not safe to send the animals against them. Let's keep everyone in the home area for now. I'm going to expand the home area to at least cover... Oh, it's already there. Okay, cool. I just need to make sure that they do not go past the walls for now. So let's get all this stuff done. Here, this is what I'll say about this current situation. What we could do... He's got 13 shooting. Jesse got a 10. Jesse, why don't you equip the chain shotgun? It's a much better gun for you. This is what I'll say about the current situation. We can't send the animals to go fight them. We probably could, but we would most definitely lose an animal. The problem with going up against Scythers... Jenna has failed in a ridiculous way while operating on Crendor. Define ridiculous way. So, not only did we lose the bandage, he now has a scratch, cuts, stabbed, a scratch, cracked tibia. Jenna, you were just supposed to do... Jenna's our highest rated doctor. How is that even possible, game? She's got a 13. She's almost max. Well, okay, not almost max, but still. I've never seen a fail that bad, especially with a heart monitor or vitals monitor, especially in a hospital bed. That's kind of ridiculous, game. The only thing I can attribute to that is that maybe the light was off, but still, that's kind of stupid. Anyway, we got to deal with the psychic ship. It's only going to make things worse for us around here. So I think what you got to do is this. I think what you got to do is we have to install. I don't want to do this, but this is the only way that I see this happening. We're going to have to install auto doors up here. And what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to aggro the ship by shooting it from... We need someone with a very accurate fire. And to keep them aggroed. We don't want them to leash. We want to keep shooting the ship so they keep coming after us. Kate, what are you doing? No. Kate, no. You can deconstruct the wall from this side. I don't want you going on the outside there. That's my fault. But you can't do that. Do not go out that way. We also need a... Someone said that actually if you make a sarcophagus for Maggie, her body parts won't rot. So that's something else that I'll go ahead and do right now, just so I don't forget. So we'll open up the tomb for now. And we'll put the sarcophagus here. We'll keep them refrigerated, but that's not a main priority right now. I'm really hoping there's just a raid that hits us. Alternatively, we could just wait for a raid. I realize some people are going to be saying, just use the mortars again. Just keep trying to use the mortars. Like, eventually you'll hit it. Were you not watching our fantastic accuracy at work? This guy also needs to be hauled away. He's sneaking up the place. So, here's what I'm going to do. I'm building these auto doors here. So, we have a very fast way of getting in and getting out of the northern quadrant of this area of the base. So... The auto doors will close behind us quicker than the mechs can actually catch up, so they're going to be forced to go around here. Whenever they go around the water, eventually they're probably going to start pathing back, but we'll have the all clear to actually just go straight for the ship. And we may even, if we can rush it, we may even have enough DPS to take down the ship before they can return back. And then without a ship, they're forced to go into our kill box, and then they're going to get absolutely wasted. Starvation, Jenna and Jesse. Oh, thank you, Rob. You didn't have to bury him, but I'm glad you did. driven the animals mad. Well, that's great. Luckily, none of our animals are going mad. I think it was a boom rat? Something happened over here. Oh, you know what? I bet they're Inferno. It was an Inferno cannon. Yep. So, the psychic pulse that the ship admitted, admitted, I should say, caused that warg that was next to him to go crazy, and they attacked it. There should be no way that they can hit me from here. Stay strong, me. You just need to hurry up, bro. No. Don't worry about repairing that. You gotta get to safety. And this needs to be hauled away. Because it's blocking the door. Dude, don't worry about repairing the wall. It's not a priority. Just haul the granite away so the doors will close. Okay. Now, I'm not going to make myself finish these doors. But we just don't want this. We don't want this to just be left there. So we got to be careful with that charge lance. Okay. There we go. Okay. Two auto doors, even though one's not finished, I can cancel it like that. Okay, so we need our best sniper. Who is our absolute best sniper that we've got? Husky. Husky's got a 15. So here's the plan. Husky is going to continually shoot the ship to keep them aggroed, and every time that we aggro, we're going to move Husky away. So Husky, I need you to go right here. You can probably hit the ship from there. Yeah. Okay, so there's the charge lance. We don't care about the Scyther. We can make it back in the base before the Scyther gets here. No, roast beef. No. Animals, don't worry about it. I appreciate the concern, but you need to stay inside the barn, all right? So you see here the centipede and the Scyther with the charge lance is actually coming towards us. Drone intensifies. Every human-like area now feels more disturbed, terrified, paranoid. This is okay. This is working. Even though this doesn't look like it's working, it's working. All he has to do is hit the ship. Okay. Get back in. Okay, the centipede is slowly coming towards us. So what we need to do is we need to get our firing squad ready to go. You've seen how tanky centipedes are, and they are not to be trifled with. So on top of Husky, we need to have... What do you need? Okay. We need to have people who are ready to go right now. A revolver's not going to be good enough. Daisy's ready to go. What does she need? What's she doing right now? Hauling components? Okay, little Daisy. We're going to have you stationed here. Invicta is eating. I'll get myself in a moment. Coach Crendor is being fed by Baynard. Jesse, what are you doing? Jesse with a chain shotgun, we need you. Yeah, see they're trying to bust through the auto door here. The centipede is pathing back. We need the charge lancer to come at us though, bro. Let's see if Husky can hit from here. He's got to be one more hex up. Now, if the Scyther gets in the base, we can handle a Scyther. What we cannot handle is a charge lance. That's why we make him out of slate. Okay, good. So they're pathing back. Husky, same thing. He's got to hit it, though. Husky, it's a non-moving target. Come on, man. You got to scope. Husky. Thank you. Okay. They're aggroed. One more shot. Okay, Centipede is through the kill box and on their way. So Vix is going to try to repair it as long as it doesn't open. Okay, Centipede's walking over the traps. It's fine. It's going to keep it aggroed. Good job, me. Major break risk, Jesse. Well, look at that. Just get out of here then, Jesse. I don't even need you then, Mr. Grouchy. Okay, good. Okay, and the Scyther's gone past the point of no return now. So this Scyther, instead of aggroing on Husky, will now always try to come through the kill box. Dodger does not have a gun. Why does Dodger not have a gun? Dodger, pick up a gun. So just these wooden deadfall traps are doing work on the Centipede. And it's so big that it's impossible for it to get around. And here we go with the first official test here. The real test. That was the sound of Dodger equipping the gun, by the way. Coach Crandor's up and moving. We've been outsmarted. The Centipede is at one hex. Are you kidding me? No. Idiot. No. The Centipede, it's one hex away from being aggroed. I cannot believe that. Okay, so that's an obvious change that we need. So that's gonna be a problem. You come over here. Baynard, we need you. We need everyone but Coach, basically. Everyone with a gun needs to get up here. Daisy, I know you're tired, I'm sorry. Kate, I know you're tired, and I know you have a rifle, I'm sorry. Dodger, Robert, Jesse's on the verge of breaking, so I'm not gonna bring him. I can't believe it's literally one hex away from aggroing the front part of the turret, but this at least exposes a very important design flaw right now. We cannot safely put out these turrets. So instead, let's take down this ship. Except for Mammy. Mammy, you stay indoors. Coach, you also stay indoors. Jesse, you stay indoors. Mammy, I said stay indoors. You're not indoors. Girl, what are you doing? Get out of here. Man, we can't lose all these turrets. What are you guys doing? You don't need to get... Yo, team, just fire at the freaking ship. Okay. Let's keep all that forbidden for now, because we have to deal with this. We straight up can't lose every single turret to fire like this. The Centipede is the biggest problem. The Centipede with the Inferno Cannon is the biggest problem. Now, I can micro around the Centipede. So, and I'm not going to put our colonists in a bad spot here. Force, what are you doing? Force, I appreciate it, but you need to go inside. Actually, no, you have a gun, Force. So we need to all. Everyone needs to focus fire the centipede. Focus fire the centipede, and then we'll take out. I gotta hope no one gets sniped out from the charge lancer. Guys. Banner with a chain shotgun. Daisy's down. Jenna, please rescue me. Rob, rescue Daisy. Kate's on fire. Dodger, don't worry about the fire. Okay, the centipede's dead. Husky's down. Kate's on fire. Force, save Husky. Jenna, please rescue me. I think Kate actually killed the charge lancer. They've done it. They've done it, team. I don't know what the final body count's gonna be, but they've done it. Unrestricted. Animals, you gotta help us. Save as many turrets as you can. Please. No. Please rescue me first. Rescue the people who need rescuing. Oh, dear Christ. Rob, you gotta move. Well, we've learned a very valuable lesson today. In that our kill box needs work, and I am gonna go to bed. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed this episode of RimWorld. I know I didn't. If you liked this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. It's easy to say that we probably deserved what just happened here. To be quite honest, if I had known about this, none of this would have happened if the kill box had just been one hex further. We would not have to be exposed like that. And, yeah. So, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.